Namaskar friends, welcome again to Legal Mind Education Series. I am Ajit Kumar, advocate and a professional family mediator. Today I am gonna talk about what is marital rape, the difference between rape and marital rape, and why marital rape has not been criminalized in Indian law. After watching this video, if you have any question, feel free to make a comment so that we can help you further. You can also give a suggestion on related topic to make any video. Okay, let's get started. While doing one of my family divorce mediation, the wife in caucus, which is a separate session, gave confidential information regarding her husband's habit of forcing himself upon her to vent out his anger. It's like a punishment to her by sexually violating her without her consent. Isn't it a rape? Or maybe worse than a rape, since she has to face her violator next morning and pretend like nothing has happened and everything is normal. Marital rape is an act of sexual intercourse with his own wife without her consent. It is a form of domestic violence which is prevalent but has not been made illegal as yet in Indian law. It is not defined in Indian Penal Code and thus has not been criminalized. It is largely not viewed as a rape by Indians due to sacred nature of marriage in Indian culture. Rape, on the other hand, has been defined in Section 375 of Indian Penal Code as engaging in sexual intercourse with a woman without her consent. It is a criminal offense and is punishable. The said section provides two exemptions. One exemption is of medical procedure, and the second exemption, which is being opposed and sought to be deleted, is of the husband, which says the husband's non-consented sexual intercourse with his wife is not a rape. This exemption in law takes away the right of wives to say no. If a wife has a right to say yes, why can't she have a right to say no? In fact, this exemption of husband in Section 375 IPC is an unconstitutional denial of equal protection of married women as provided to unmarried women. It violates the fundamental right of equality before law and right to privacy. A married woman has same right of full control over her body as an unmarried woman, which incorporates bodily integrity, sexual autonomy and choice and reproductive choice. The recognition of the marital rape is the outcome of social change in our society. However, a similar change in law has been opposed by the government for various reasons, such as that making rape in marriage a crime would be misused by the woman, like previously in Section 498 cases. Further, marriage is a sacred institution and the marital rape instances are very rare. Similarly, like DV Act is also there for protection of women's right, and like marital privacy makes such offenses very difficult to be proved in court, and further that making it a crime would destabilize the marriage and would make a marriage more tougher. However, the basic fact is ignored that rape is a rape and marriage cannot be a justification. It is a threat to the institution of marriage itself. A husband is supposed to love and trust and not to violate the trust by violating her body. There are more than 100 countries which has criminalized the marital rape. However, in India it is opposed by the government for various reasons. The reasons given by the government can be properly responded like by giving these responses. Like, marital privacy is not meant to shield the abuse, and further apprehending the misuse or labeling all wives to be potentially vindicative is poor stereotype. It can also be said that there are various crimes which without witnesses are hard to be proved, yet they cannot be a reason to make a crime unprosecutable. Making rape in marriage a crime is not going to make the marriage difficult. On the contrary, rape itself makes a marriage difficult. Further, DV Act at best can make it a domestic violence or a cruelty, a ground justifying for a divorce, but cannot make it a rape due to the exemption of Section 375 IPC. So a change in social mindset is required. Frankly, Indian men can't accept no or rejection. It is the mental thought process which is required to be changed. And that's it. For more videos on related legal topic, be sure to subscribe our channel by clicking here and tap the bell, and that will allow you to get notification for each and every video uploaded. And if you have any question, leave the comment below. Thanks for watching.